Today we are going to discuss about this particular new poem. The poem is Fire and Ice. This poem has been written by Robert Frost. Okay? If you go through the theme of the poem, then we find that the theme of the poem is very important. The poet thinks that there are many ideas in this world, okay, which are with the capability to destroy the world. It means in this world there are different kind of the ideas, and if we are not going to address these kind of the ideas and opinion, then there is a probability that our earth is going to be destroyed. This is the first important thing. The second important thing which we should also discuss, that as we know that in the opinion of the poet that probably this earth may destroy, okay, but what is the reason of that destruction? And so the poet thinks that fire and ice both are capable, okay, for the destruction of this particular world. In another sense, actually it is related to the it is targeted for the earth. So the fire and ice, I mean the fire and ice, both are really important, or you can say risky, for the destruction of this earth. So under that, it has under the fire and the ice, there are certain ideology which has been selected as if we are unable to address all these ideas, either equivalent to fire or equivalent to the ice, in that condition it is quite difficult to save our earth. So what are these ideas? This is the one of the most important thing. Now fire indicates in other ways. Fire means, okay, so fire is a symbolic representation, ice is also a symbolic representation. So you can say that fire and ice have been used in this poem as a metaphor. So fire represents greed, lalach, conflict, avarice, fury, anger, cruelty, lust, and at the same time, okay, desire. And so if we are not going to stop the people from the burning of the fire of desire, then probably this fire of desire, this burning fire of the desire, probably is enough for the destruction of this particular earth. Okay, so this is I think that this one is really the most important question. Here, at this point of the time, I want to discuss, or I want to share you one of the most important things, or the question, that what would happen if the sun got so hot that it burst? This is the real question. Okay, and at the same time, if the sun is going to be hot and hotter and hottest, then probably that would be the time when our earth is going to burn completely. Okay, second important information, or the second important question, is already here in front of us. And this question is that, contrary to being hot, if we find that, okay, the sun started losing its brightness and the heat, and it is getting cold and colder, then what will happen? What would happen to our earth? Similarly, okay, you will find that there may be the icy age, and suddenly you will find that everything is going to destroy on this particular earth. So you will find that the poet has used fire and ice as a metaphor to represent that there are many ideas equivalent to the fire. It means like the fire, they are as destructive as fire. And similarly, there are many ideas which are equivalent to the ice, and they are as destructive as ice. And so we are going to discuss about this in the coming stanzas. Okay, so I have the first stanza is already in front of you all. So let's begin with this first stanza of this particular poem. Some say the world will end in fire. Some say the world will end in fire. Some say in ice. This line represents that there is a division of opinion among the people. So in a simple way we can say that there are two school of thoughts, there are two opposing ideas regarding the destruction of the earth. Okay, destruction of the world. Okay, you know that people are sure that this world is going to destroy, this world is going to end, but okay, what is the agent? It means how. So here, one school of thought, one group of the philosophers are saying the world will end in fire. This is the first one. Second, the another group of the philosophers are contemplating. Another group of the philosophers are saying or suggesting that no, okay, it is due to ice. And so we are having the two options. So fire or ice. But probably these two are the only instrument or the agent. Okay, due to that there would be the destruction of the world. Okay, now here you will find that some say and saying some say. So you will find that these two consecutive sentences are begin with the same group of word or the same word. Okay, so if you are having such kind of the setting in the poem where the two continuous poem, I mean the line of a particular poem is going to begin with the same, I mean the word or group of the word, then it is the example of one of the most important poetic device that is known as the anaphora. So this is the example of anaphora. And so some say the world will end in fire, some say in ice. Now moving closer. From what I have tasted, I have tasted of desire. Okay, so the narrator is telling us from his own experience, and so okay, his experience says that this is the desire. This is the desire. So what I have tasted of desire, and so from his own opinion or the experience, narrator equated the fire equivalent to the desire, and so he says that I hold with those who favor fire. It means in his opinion, the world may destroy, the world will end in fire, okay, because people across the world are burning in the fire of desire. So desire is here the instrumental. So you will find that fire has been used here symbolically or as a metaphor. So the poet said that it is the desire. Okay, it is my own experience that it is the desire of the people, and if you are unable to control, okay, in that condition, people are sorry this world will end fire because they all are burning in the fire of desire. Okay, that's clear. Now we are coming to here the another part of world and the will. So again the same consonant later is being repeated. So it is the example of you can say same letter is being repeated. So word will, and so it is the example of what. Similarly you will find that it is again F and F here. So all these are the examples of what. These are the examples of alliteration. Second, you will find that if you are going through the setting of the the sentences, then you will find that here we are having the O letter, again who, again O letter, and again favor. So these middle vowel nouns are prominent in this sentence. So you will find that it is another kind of the poetic device that is known as the assonance. Okay, so in this way you find that the stanza describes that poets, it is the opinion of the poet, and poet is going to favor that opinion who says that the world will end in fire, because he is saying, or it is his own experience, that people are burning with the fire of desire, and so probably the world will end. Okay, so now we are moving to the second stanza of this particular poem. Okay, here the most important word is Paris. Okay, so what is the meaning of the Paris? Paris means dark. Okay, so in this stanza, it is the opinion of the poet that but as we know that in the beginning, in the first stanza, the poet declared that this world will end in fire. And now here is the second opinion of the poet. And what is the second opinion? It says, but if it had to die twice. For example, you are giving me the second option. Okay, you are telling me ki no. You tell me if the world is going to destroy two times, in that condition what is your opinion? So in that case poet says, but if it had to perish twice, it had to destroy twice, then what is your opinion? And so the poet says, I know enough of hate. It means there is second school of the idea. The second idea that is as destructive as the destruction created by the eyes to this world. And so the poet said that I have experience of the hate. Hate is nothing but really very icy one. And so there are many ideas associated with the eyes, equivalent to the hatred. So the poet say that hatred is also enough for the destruction of the world, without it is equivalent to the eyes. And so to say that for destruction eyes is also great. It means the world will end in eyes, the world will destroy in eyes, and especially this is the hatred and the other related ideas, whether it is insensitivity, coldness, intolerance, indifference, rigidity, or even the hatred in there. And so he say that this would be sufficient. This is going to be the enough one for the destruction of this particular earth. So you will find that the poet is having the suggestive mood here, the poet is talking about the destruction of this world, and you know that we have to. So here you will find that fire and ice is a metaphor. And at the same time, if you are going to the other part, then you will find that to say that for destruction ice is also great, you will find that these two sentences are creating image. So it is the example of imagery poetic device also. Okay, and in this way you will find that there are many things, otherwise there's nothing special here. And in this way I hope that you understand, you go through the poem and try to understand the inherent ideas, and on the basis of that you are going to be ready for your final examination. Okay then, bye.